Can you name the 10 largest companies in the world? If you regularly watch our channel, you probably already know most of them. After a blistering rally of more than 200% since last October, NVIDIA has become the sixth largest company in the world with a $1 trillion valuation.
So is this valuation justified? Why is NVIDIA all the rage right now? And what dynamics made it one of the largest companies in the world?
Let's find out. Hey there, this is Stephanie, tech veteran, engineer, and creator.
And I'm Bertrand, founder of App Economy Insights. NVIDIA is the world's leading graphics and AI company. And in the words of NVIDIA CEO Jensen Huang,
we are at the iPhone moment for AI.
They make advanced tech that powers everything from your favorite video games to self-driving cars. NVIDIA uses its expertise in graphics processing to create some of the most advanced AI systems out there. It's used to do everything from making movies to solving complex scientific problems.
It's the world's top producer of discrete graphics processing units, GPUs, for PCs and data centers. Discrete, meaning with its own dedicated memory. GPUs have been used to accelerate calculations involving large amounts of data, a need that will increase over time. That's why the surge in demand for generative AI is a huge tailwind for NVIDIA. And NVIDIA isn't just about the future, they're also driving the present. Their graphics cards are the go-to choice for gamers, and they're also used in all sorts of other applications.
In short, NVIDIA is making some seriously impressive tech, and it's at the forefront of the AI revolution. They are targeting a $1 trillion market opportunity when combining all markets NVIDIA touches. The company made $27 billion in revenue in fiscal year 2023, so the runway ahead remains gigantic.
If you are new to the semiconductor industry or find terms like CPU, GPU, and TPU puzzling, we've got a 7-minute video where we dive into the bottom of the AI tech stack and explain the vital roles of companies like NVIDIA, AMD, and TSMC in the race towards AI supremacy. So it's a really good place to start.
NVIDIA's management breaks down the company's performance through 5 primary markets. Gaming used to be the bread and butter of the company, making up about half of the revenue in 2020, and it still makes about a third of the revenue today. This segment includes GeForce GPUs and its GeForce streaming service and solutions. Data center has become the most important category and makes up 60% of revenue. They include systems for AI, high-performance computing, and accelerated computing.
The other categories are still small, but have a lot of potential. We have professional visualization solutions, including complex 3D modeling, simulation, and animation. And then automotive, including infotainment systems and autonomous driving solutions. Finally, OEM and other, including cryptocurrency mining processors.
While generative AI and the need for accelerated computing have been a boon for the data center category, it's crucial to note that the semiconductor industry is very cyclical. Periods of high demand cause supply shortages followed by gluts, and that's precisely what happened in the gaming segment in the past year.
This chart shows NVIDIA's revenue in the past 10 quarters, which paints a challenging time in the past year caused by the decline in the gaming segment. Take note that NVIDIA's fiscal year ends in January, so they just ended the first quarter of the fiscal year 24 in April. COVID boosted the need for at-home entertainment, creating a combination of skyrocketing demand and limited supply caused by a chip shortage in 2021. This supply shortage was followed by a supply glut in 2022. NVIDIA's gaming segment saw reduced shipments as the company worked to align channel inventory, meaning products already on shelves at retail. As a result, gaming revenue dropped dramatically. However, the channel inventory levels have normalized, and now gaming shows a rebound driven by the new GeForce RTX 40 series GPUs.
As a gaming industry veteran, I expect gaming to benefit from long-term tailwinds well beyond the post-COVID hangover. Each new generation shows higher gaming penetration. 81% of Gen Z play games, and they spend more than 7 hours per week. PC gaming might become a smaller portion of the market, but the overall industry is expected to expand with new needs around streaming. Now, let's talk more about data center. NVIDIA CFO Colette Kress recently touched on the 3 major customer categories. First, cloud service providers, CSPs. All hyperscalers like Amazon, Microsoft and Google are NVIDIA customers and partners with strong demand for the flagship H100 data center GPU. Next, we have consumer internet companies. For example, Meta powers its Grand Teton AI supercomputer with H100 chips. Finally, we have large enterprises. Demand for AI and accelerated computing is touching all sectors, from automotive to financials to healthcare and telecom. Everyone is getting a large language model, or LLM for short. All three customer categories are driving the surge in demand for generative AI and accelerated computing.
A company's valuation is about its future, not its past. So it's critical to look at product innovation. At the GTC 2023 keynote, the company made many announcements focusing on AI. Among the most important ones, NVIDIA DGX Cloud, an AI supercomputer in the cloud offering a multi-node AI training as a service solution tailored for enterprise AI demands. The company announced NVIDIA AI Foundations. These are cloud services for language, visual media, and biology, enabling companies like Adobe to create, refine, and operate custom generative AI and large language models. They include NVIDIA NeMo for language, a toolkit for building conversational AI models. NVIDIA Picasso for visuals, generates photorealistic images, video, and 3D. NVIDIA BioNeMo for biology, pre-trained and 3D protein prediction models. NVIDIA also launched 4 inference platforms for LLM and generative AI workloads, chatbots, text-to-image content, AI video, and more.
A significant partnership with Microsoft was revealed to connect Omniverse platform to Microsoft 365 applications. Omniverse is a platform for industrial visualization and 3D design. Microsoft will bring the industrial metaverse to millions of existing enterprise users through Azure Cloud. One new product that caught my attention in the recent Computex 2023 keynote in Taiwan was the announcement of the NVIDIA Avatar Cloud Engine, or ACE. We had a taste of how AI foundational models can bring life to NPCs, non-playable characters, in games. The demo showed an NPC responding to a human player in real time, with the dialogues generated with AI on the fly. I can't wait to see how storytelling will evolve in games with this technology.
At the same conference, Jensen Huang discussed the end of Moore's Law and the new need for accelerated computing stemming from AI, specifically generative AI. We can't cover all of this in the video, but in short, he believes NVIDIA is uniquely positioned by addressing the full stack with the 3 S's: silicon, systems, and software. And keep in mind, accelerated computing is only one element of NVIDIA's multi-sided platform and flywheel. Huang sees a virtuous cycle in product adoption across developers, computer makers, cloud service providers, and enterprise customers. More people in the ecosystem means more reach and better performance for everyone involved. Let's talk about NVIDIA's competitive advantage. In Jensen Huang's view, the two critical competitive challenges are: accelerated computing is a full stack problem. Generative AI is a large scale problem. So NVIDIA is well positioned to solve these challenges thanks to its scale compared to smaller new entrants, and full stack capabilities with software solutions complementing hardware.
Too much focus is on the chips and the potential for competitors to build comparable chips over time. But the software and networking around the chips are just as essential and should not be overlooked. We often discussed on this channel how Apple managed to build a giant services business on top of its hardware sales. It's the same logic here.
Both infrastructure and architecture matter. To illustrate, Jensen Huang pointed out the speed of delivery and the expertise of NVIDIA in deploying data centers and supercomputers for its customers. In short, the market will remain very competitive, but only very few companies can overcome the type of challenges posed by generative AI and accelerated computing.
Okay. Let's look at NVIDIA's financials using one of my diagrams. I'm focusing on sequential growth quarter over quarter to show how things are improving or not following the recent challenging quarters. Of note, revenue grew 19% sequentially, driven by both the rebound in gaming, jumping 22%, and a continued surging demand for generative AI, leading to data center growing 18% sequentially. It was 10% ahead of Wall Street's expectations, making it a huge revenue beat.
Another thing that should jump at you here is NVIDIA margins. The company has maintained an elevated gross margin, even during a challenging phase of the cycle for gaming. Currently sitting at 65% of revenue, management expects the gross margin to improve to 69% next quarter following inventory improvements. But here comes the mic drop moment of the recent earnings call. Management said they expect Q2 FY24 revenue to be $11 billion. That's a 53% jump sequentially. Wall Street expected only $7.2 billion. This type of outperformance is unheard of. We would have to go back to Zoom video during the peak of the pandemic to find this type of guidance beat.
NVIDIA has sparked debate with its high valuation. Recently, ARK Invest's Cathie Wood and NYU's finance professor Aswath Damodaran have voiced concerns about NVIDIA's valuation, hinting that it's ahead of the curve and hard to justify holding. The company's valuation multiples appear inflated due to the recent gaming segment's underperformance. The trailing price-to-earnings and price-to-sales ratios, relying on the past year's lower earnings and sales, seem inflated. As you can see in this chart, NVIDIA is trading at ridiculous multiples of earnings and sales compared to its historical range.
However, a more accurate measure is the forward multiple based on next year's earnings and sales estimates because it excludes the ebb and flow from gaming, and it puts NVIDIA at around 50 times forward earnings. So get this, despite recently tripling its stock price, NVIDIA's valuation is actually lower than in early 2022 due to improved fundamentals. Historically, NVIDIA consistently beats Wall Street's EPS consensus, with the exception of the big gaming slowdown last year. This type of outperformance can compound over time, and it's what can create a lot of alpha for shareholders. Most analysts on Wall Street assume linear decelerating growth in their models, which could be wrong when it comes to generative AI. Even if we assume NVIDIA only meets future expectations, it's trading at 19 times the FY28 EPS. Today, a company like Apple is trading at 30 times EPS. Given this, NVIDIA may be less overvalued than it seems and could potentially appreciate by over 50% over the next 5 years. So the company could grow into its valuation quickly.
Investing involves weighing probabilities. As stated by Annie Duke in her book Thinking in Bets, it's about making decisions that accurately represent our knowledge. A wider range of outcomes translates into higher risk. In investing terms, the more uncertain the outcome, the more important it is to watch position sizing, which is how much is allocated to a specific stock in a portfolio. Personally, the more uncertain I am about an outcome, the less I'm likely to add to my position.
If generative AI demand continues to surge over the next decade, the company could exceed expectations, but potential risks include fading AI hype, commoditization of NVIDIA solutions, and competition from larger companies investing in their own technologies. It wouldn't take many hiccups for NVIDIA's stock price to be cut in half. If you want an example, just look at Tesla in the past year.
Right. There is no way to know where the stock will trade in the near term. I own NVIDIA shares and plan to hold them for many years, but haven't added to my position since last year. At this valuation, I'm not planning to add more. Interestingly, with $7 billion available for stock buybacks, management hasn't repurchased any shares recently. Yet, they repurchased $10 billion of NVIDIA shares in FY23. So, it looks like they agree. The stock is not particularly compelling at this time.
One thing is certain. If you are an NVIDIA shareholder or if you are considering investing, you must understand the dynamics with its customers. From cloud service providers to consumer internet companies, in our AI war video series, we cover how these companies navigate AI innovation and try to come out on top. So, see you right there.